What's happening, everyone? I hope all of you are doing fantastic. Today is a special video dedicated to you guys because I went across many of my social media channels and asked around what topics you guys were very curious to find out more information on, and it seemed pretty unanimous. You guys are super keen on finding out how I prepare some of my Instagram reels and of course TikTok videos. Be sure to follow me on both platforms, that is, first. But the idea today is to walk you through the step-by-step process, show you how I create these reels, and what kind of apps I'm using to really create these videos. But before we get into all that, actually wait, my arm's hurting. I'm gonna put this camera down, 1 second. This is much better. My arm was giving out. I had a crazy workout this week. But today's video is sponsored by Ergon Office. If you're not familiar with Ergon Office, they're one of Canada's top office furniture manufacturers. They design amazing desks like this right here, and they've gifted me an entire working station, which I really am ecstatic to talk to you guys about, and something that I've been really, really missing in my workflow. I've always had just plain simple chair and kind of desk that I've used as a setup, and let's just say it didn't work. And this has definitely changed my experience in terms of how I create content, how I stay motivated and inspired to continue to create content for you guys. So let's get into the nitty gritty. I wanna walk you guys through some of these amazing products, and then we'll get back into the video topic. So to kind of give you an overview of Ergon Office, I wanna start off by saying that they are a Canadian office furniture company based out of Quebec. In designing their furniture, they really take a look into considering the constant challenges we face when working, and the ability to feel inspired and grow while keeping up with our daily tasks. They design high quality solid wood and soft touch standing desks and office furniture that you should definitely take a look at. The products here are absolutely amazing. The manufacturing quality, the design, and the overall aesthetic is just perfect. I have here the suede desk made from walnut. It's 30 by 60 inches. I have a cable management solution, which is super useful. The desk drawer for all the little things. Neat filing cabinet, which comes super handy for managing important documents. I have the U2 ergonomic chair in iron honey leather combo and black frame. The desk shelf, which is also in walnut. And the leather desk pad in black. I'm super excited about this office setup, but as you guys can see, I still need some sort of art on the wall. I still need to paint the wall. There's quite a little bit of other things that need to be done. I just got back from my travel, so this is all step-by-step process, but what I really enjoy is building the furniture, you know, really preparing things and going about the workday experience. Another thing I really want to mention is that if you do have any questions regarding some of the furniture, I'll be sure to leave all the information down below. You can also find it at ergonoffice.com. As always, guys, go check it out. Be sure to check it out because this is something that you will definitely find really useful in your day-to-day life. If you're someone who works at home or if you need new office furniture at your office, no matter where you are, Ergon Office is really creating furniture that is very useful and that will make your daily work a lot more enjoyable because it inspires you to be more creative. Now, before I get into the full details of creating reels on InShot, I just want to quickly shout out GroveMade. GroveMade sent me a whole bunch of accessories for my desktop setup. They're an amazing accessories company that makes accessories for your home and your office space. They sent me a laptop stand, a headphone stand, even a pen, and a bunch of other cool, really nice accessories to put on my desk. Be sure to check them out. I'll leave all their information down below. They make really well-designed accessories that can really last a long time and something that looks super aesthetic and that will fit your office space very well. So check out their information down below. All right, guys, I know that you guys are anxiously waiting to find out how I create these reels on Instagram and on my TikTok. And it's very simple, I'll be honest with you. I use this application called InShot. It's a free application. I know that you can obviously pay for certain things like removing the logo and stuff like that, but I have the subscription. You can pay for it. It's super cheap. It's not too expensive. But the application is super useful. It lets you create visuals, cinematic videos that really allow your audience to kind of journey with you and experience. And this is something that I've been trying to really incorporate in my visuals and or my content. It's just really telling a story and allowing people to almost feel like as though they are traveling with me. So here are some examples of videos that I put together on this application.
Taking it, feeling lit, feeling like 2 a.m. summer night. tonight.
So as you guys saw from those video clips, they're all very moody, they all have a certain vibe to them. The sounds and the music selection is very important here. And I want to walk you through the step-by-step process of how I go about, you know, creating the visuals, choosing the song, and so on and so forth. The first and foremost is choosing the song. I think I get a lot of my inspiration for the type of visuals I create through the music I listen to. And over the years, my musical taste has changed, and obviously there's certain apps that are, provoking and also introducing us to new types of music, like TikTok being one of them. For some of these videos, I simply was just inspired by some of these TikTok video songs that I saw. They're not the, you know, regular dancing ones. These are a little bit different. But the idea is you start off with the song, you choose the song that you want, and then you come up with a theme for your video. So the theme has to work with the song. This is very important. It's not the other way around. Some people film stuff and then they're like, okay, I need to choose a song. But I've realized over the years that's not the right way to approach videos, especially when they're short and they're, you know, they have the purpose of just pure entertainment. So for these videos, I really thought about the music, and then after the music process, I came up with a concept. I said, you know what, I'm in Barcelona and it's the end of September. It's really moody out. There's a lot of rain. We're getting lightning. It's turning super, the atmosphere is changing, and I wanted to capture the atmosphere change. I wanted to capture visuals that really gave someone a flow, you know, some sort of experience. Here's an example of a video that I filmed there that really works well with that change of season. So in that video, you might have noticed that it's super desaturated, it's super moody, but it works really well with the song. And this is the thought process that I had. I said, okay, this is the song I want, these are the beats. The intervals I have to film for each of these beats is about 10 seconds. So I went out and I captured different scenes of things that I was doing, but making sure that I kept in mind the song element. And the element of the song is to really sway you in this like atmospheric, very kind of chill type of vibe. And so I wanted visuals that would help, you know, really drive home that message, make you feel a little bit of emotional connection to the city, you know, whether or not it's rain, people dancing, you know, like just outings and lighting and all these things that are super kind of, you know, cinematic in a sense. But then you stitch them together on the application and it's super easy. You collect all the visuals and you just simply import them in and you cut them to the beat of the track, and the timeline is super seamless to work with. Once you have your music and your visuals in sync and it works well with the beat, you can go ahead even start to color grade your visuals. And the application has different LUTs that they already provide for you to color grade, or you can manually edit and color each of the videos itself and apply it seamlessly across all the videos. Once you're done that, you can go ahead and do effects. So in effects, they have grains, they have flares, they have all the different types of visual effects that you can apply to your video. And be sure to kind of experiment with all these things, because they will allow you to kind of create this creative process or this visual process that you want to kind of share with your audiences. Once you're done that, it's as seamless as just exporting the video and having it ready on your mobile device and ready to share. And the beauty of our mobile devices nowadays is that they have very good cameras. So you're filming with really good camera quality and you're able to edit on an application that's able to export a high resolution visual as well. So from there, you just share it. You kind of come up with the storyline of what the visual is, and you wait for your audience to kind of react. And this process has been super eye-opening for me, because I always had the standard of filming with my mirrorless camera or my DSLR back then, and creating very high production quality content and sharing it online and realizing, oh my God, it took me a full day to film one thing, when sometimes that might not be the best option for you. And it depends on the type of content that you want to share and the type of artist that you want to kind of be perceived as. For me, it's about creating visuals that do seem very high-end quality, but that are not going to take my, you know, take me weeks and days to produce. The reason why is because social media, unfortunately, doesn't allow content to last long. And so because of that pace, you want to create visuals that, you know, don't, you know, exhaust you. Not to say that you shouldn't, you should work on projects that you feel super excited about and that might take you higher production value and might take you a lot more time. But when days are, you know, shorter and you need to produce something very quickly, this is a great application for you to utilize and a great technique for you to incorporate in your content. So the video is pretty short. I just wanted to kind of inspire you guys to check out this application, create some cool reels, tag me in them, send them to me. You can email them to me, whatever you like. I would love to check out the content that you guys are producing. I do hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Always remember to like, subscribe, and comment, and I'll see you guys very soon. Peace.